everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today I am doing a room tour of my room at home. I have done two room tours so far, but those were both my dorms back at college the first 2 years. But I figured now I would do a room tour of my room at home because I am obsessed with my room at home. I actually started redoing my room about a year and a half ago. I live on the third floor of my family's farmhouse, and before it used to be used for storage and miscellaneous things like that, and it was a wreck in here. The walls were all like purple and it was just not cute at all. But it was so much work to get it done, and I finished about a year ago. It only took a couple months, honestly, from start to finish. And I could have done this video like last summer, but there was so much more things I wanted to add. It still felt really bare. And over the past year or so, I added a lot of things to the room and I am absolutely in love with it. But I am moving out in like 2 days to my college town. I am living in a house there and I'm gonna be in that house for 2 years as of right now. So I figured before I move a lot of the stuff out, I would do a room tour just to show y'all what my room looks like, because I always get so much compliments on it and it is so cute in my opinion. It is definitely not everyone's style, but I am obsessed with it and I'm going to miss this room so much. I definitely am going to try my hardest to make my room at school really cute, but this room is just really unique. It's really big. I have a ton of space and I've really just made it my own, and it was really fun to just like play with colors and go thrifting for things. I would guess probably like 95% of the decor in my room is from the thrift store. Like pretty much all of it. I don't really buy a lot of the stuff in here brand new. Anyways, I'm just going to give y'all an in-depth tour of the room. Before I show y'all, I will insert some videos right now of what the room looked like before. And honestly, I am so proud of this room. I know not everyone will like it or think it's basic or whatever, but I am obsessed with it and I am so happy. And this room really is my pride and joy. I'm so sad to leave. And of course, I will be back for breaks and all, but I'm bringing most of my decor to school with me, so it will not look the same. This room means so much to me and I'm so excited to share it with y'all, and I really hope y'all love it as much as I do. And there is a lot of room to cover, by the way. I will try not to go too in-depth to every single piece of it. And I have been wanting to do this for so long, so I'm so excited. I'm actually sitting down and making myself finally do this. And I really hope y'all enjoy it. I'm so excited to show y'all this room. I really hope y'all love it as much as I do. And let's get into it. Okay, so I'm going to start right here. So this is the door where you come in, and like I said, I live on the third floor, so it looks like this right outside of my room. Coming up, I have this little blanket ladder right here. There aren't any blankets right now on it because a lot of my things are all packed away to go to school. And then I have these vines coming up, and then a pink light, and it looks really cool at night. I really love this part. And then right here I have this Babe Cave sign, kind of basic, but I got it from Five Below, I believe, and there are a lot of these vines around my room. I think I got them in a pack from Amazon. This is my first window right here. It looks out to the chimney, and you can kind of see the pool yard over there. And I have a bunch of these little plants at the corner of a lot of the windows. They came in a pack of 6, I think, from IKEA, and of course they're just these fake little succulents, and I think it just made the windowsill a little less boring. I'm actually not going to go into my closet because it is a total mess. I do not want y'all to see any of that, but it's just a walk-in closet. It's pretty decent size. So heading over here, we have my full-length mirror, and this is literally the best full-length mirror ever. I'm obsessed with it. I think it is about 8 feet tall. I'm not really sure. It's from IKEA. Really suggested. It is the best for outfit pictures and all that. I do my makeup in here, and I think it was only like $130, which I think is pretty good for the price. And over here we have these vines that are hanging down, and I really just like the look of this. And now heading over here, this is my clothing rack, and I think it's really just a good way to display clothes and also just extra closet space. And on the corners I keep a lot of bags, and I really like that this comes in handy because it's cute but also functional. I have bags on either side. And down here it is basically a little shoe rack. Heading to the next part of the room, this is my side table. I normally have some sort of coffee cup on here at all times because I really like drinking hot coffee in the morning. And this is just a little catch-all plate type of thing. It looks like a leaf, clearly. And I got this from the thrift store a while back. I got down so y'all could see better. But this mirror I also thrifted, and I am absolutely obsessed with it. Before I painted it, it was this weird brown wood and it really just did not look good. So then I got the idea to get some gold spray paint, and it literally took me 10 minutes to repaint this mirror, and I think that it looks so cute now. I had it in my dorm last year also. And then heading off to the side right here, this is my IKEA lamp. I actually use it all the time. Sometimes when I don't want the overhead lighting, I really like to just use some lamps. And right here is my snake plant. Recently, I have been getting really into plants. You'll see a lot more of my plants as we go through the room tour. This is one of my recent favorite thrift finds, vintage looking lamp, and it is so cute. I really love having random pops of color like this in my room. It's not even plugged in, so I feel kind of fake for that. And I just have random stuff in all of these drawers. I don't even know. It is basically a junk drawer type of side table. And this is my bed. It is so comfy. The bed frame is from IKEA. And I really like how low it is to the ground. It's not too high, but not extremely low. I think it is the perfect height. And I just have a ton of pillows on here and some throw pillows. And my sheets right now are actually purple. They aren't always purple, but lately I've been keeping them on because I think it really brightens up the room and adds a pop of color besides just white. This is a strawberry pillow that I got from one of my sorority sisters. This is Wolfie. My boyfriend got him for me, and he is so cute. And I just have this fuzzy white blanket at the bottom, and my dogs really like laying on that. But yeah, basically this is my bed, and I normally keep my book bag down here for some reason. I'm not really sure why, but there's a little space, so I always keep it down there because I'm typically always reaching for my laptop. And this is my other side table. I have this little wooden hand bowl that I think is the most adorable thing ever. And I keep all of my crystals in here, and I think it's a really cute way of displaying them. This actually isn't a thrift find. I found this at a store in Charleston called Earthbound. Right here is a fake plant. I'm pretty sure I got this from IKEA or Five Below. I really don't remember. And then coming down here, I have this little fake aloe plant that holds a picture, and this is a disposable picture I took of my cousins. And coming over here, I have this painting that my stepmom made me, and it is so pretty. It goes with the colors of my room really well, and I just think it brings everything together. This is a card that my boyfriend wrote me, and it is so cute. I love it because it has little doggies on it, and it also does go with the color of my room. And on this side, I have this little rainbow picture holder thing, and it is another film picture I took about a year ago of my cousins. And then I have this empty vase. Normally I have fresh flowers in it, but I am about to leave for school in like 2 days, so I haven't gotten any recently. This next part of my room is probably my favorite part of the whole room. I have this fire escape, and it is so cool. I love showing people it. So you just step out here. So this is what it looks like out on the fire escape. It is a really good view from up here. I live on a horse farm, like I said, and like you can tell now. So you can see everything from up here. Sometimes I will drink my morning coffee up here. I have these two chairs that I spray painted green. They were originally like this weird color. And I never go down this ladder, but this is the ladder for if there is a fire. So hopefully I won't ever have to use that. And I think this is really unique, and not a lot of people can say that they have their own fire escape, so it is really sick. Okay, so this is the next part of the room. This is my dresser, holds a lot of clothes, and actually all of the dressers and side tables I painted. It was originally this weird light brown color, but I repainted them all white and redid the hardware, and I think that it turned out amazing. I love these, and I think it just really blends in well with the walls. And this is what I have on top of here, just a bunch of random things, some books. I have my Polaroid camera, a random disposable that I think I need to take to Walgreens. This is just a vase I also keep fresh flowers in. This is a little plant thing from IKEA. This is a painting I actually painted while I was in quarantine. It's one of my favorite things I've ever painted. I've recently gotten into painting, so I know it's not the best. And I just think the colors of this really goes well with my room. I feel kind of bad for this because this is kind of gross, but these are these old flowers that I have had probably for over a month, maybe 2 months, honestly. And then this is just another succulent from IKEA. I'm pretty sure I got this fake flower plant thing from the thrift store. This is a film picture I took of my boyfriend a while back, and I put it in this really pretty golden frame that I thrifted. And this is a San Pellegrino bottle that really just reminds me of a really good time whenever my cousins and I went on this really pretty picnic in the mountains. And then these are just fake plants that I got from IKEA. And all of these vases, besides that one, are all thrifted. This is my other dresser, holds a ton of clothes. That is one thing I also love about this room. I have a ton of space for clothing. And this is my TV. I'm not really sure if y'all can tell, but it is absolutely huge. I love watching movies on here. I play all my music on here, watching YouTube. It is the best. And another thing about this TV is it is extremely thin. Like, have y'all ever seen a TV that thin? I don't know, that's kind of random, but just thought I would show y'all that. In this little corner right here, I have this moon mirror that I got from Five Below, and this is my diffuser. And I love this diffuser, it lights up. And I love using my little essential oils. I really just like making sure my room smells good at all times. So either this is always going or a candle. Now coming over here, I have this tall lamp. I really never use this, honestly. This area is probably one of my favorite parts of the whole room. Before we redid this room, the ceiling actually went like this, but we redid it so that it would go up and it was a little higher over here, and we installed a chandelier and it turned out so amazing. I am so obsessed with this room. Oh, and I forgot to note, all of the ceilings used to be this weird, ugly brown color, and we replaced it with this really nice wood. And I think it just goes really well with the beams, and it really makes the whole room pop. That is another thing I love about this room. I keep saying that, but I just love these beams. They are so pretty, and I think they're really unique. Okay, going back over here, I have this old furnace. This furnace is not used anymore, clearly, but I really like the look of it. And I have these disco balls that I got from Five Below a while back, and I think that they are so cute. But one of my favorite things about them is that they, like, scatter light everywhere. These little, like, all these little things, like, they're all over my room, depending on the time of day. And as you can tell, they're all over here also, and it really just adds a pretty effect to the room. This is another one of my plants. He has grown a lot, actually, since I got him. He used to be up here, and he has grown quite a bit. This is a fake IKEA plant I have. I'm not really a big fan of fake plants anymore since I've gotten into real ones, but I still have a couple hanging out around the room. And this is a second full-length mirror, and I probably take most of my pictures in this one, honestly, because the light in this little, like, cove is so much better than it is over there. And it is just perfect for pictures. This mirror is also pretty tall, but what I also like about it is really wide and has this, like, nice black border. And I just hang my big tote bag right here, and I think it looks really cute. And yeah, this is, like, the perfect picture spot. I like having my plants right here also. This little cove is probably my favorite part of the whole room. Down here, I have these thrifted picnic baskets, which are one of my favorite thrift finds ever. They are so cute, and they go really well with my room, but also I love going on picnics, so they're super useful. This is my fern. She's doing all right. I think I need to repot her. I got this from HomeGoods a couple months ago, and I just put a random fake IKEA plant I have in it, and I just have her sitting on this little stool I got from IKEA. It was literally only $5 and took me 2 seconds to assemble. Coming down here, this is one of my new art pieces that I did, and I really love it. I think it really goes well with my room, and I just love the meaning behind it. I've made a couple others, but I gave them away as gifts. And then right next to it, this is a little plant stand. It's kind of short, and I got it from a flea market for really cheap, and I just love all the details on this. And this is another plant that my boyfriend and I got together. It's a prayer plant, actually. I think it's a prayer plant. And I actually originally just had it in this plain pot, but then I painted it and painted a bunch of evil eyes all over it. And this is what it looks like down here. It's a little dirty. Heading over to more plants. This plant is my newest one. She is my pride and joy. She's actually sprouted a couple of new leaves the past couple weeks. And now for the last thing in this little cove area is this mirror. I used to always take pictures in this mirror before I put this one up here, but it is so cute. It is this vintage looking gold mirror, and I got it for like $30 from the thrift store, which I feel like is a steal. Now the last part of my room that I had to show y'all is this area. This is this antique plant stand that is actually really old, and it's been in my family for a little bit, and stand. It's probably not normally a plant stand, it's a side table, but I call it a plant stand because I have my plant on here. This is my Hawaiian pothos. I think that's what it's called, don't quote me on it. And she has grown a lot since I got her. She's starting to hang down some. And then down here, I just have this green antique vase. And then next I have this cat mug and there's probably still coffee in it. But I got this from a flea market a while back and it is the cutest little mug ever. And then this is what I use to mist my plants. I normally mist my fern the most out of all of the plants, but I actually use this almost every day. Now coming over here, I have this recliner and it is this like ugly brown color. Well, it really isn't that ugly, but I really just did not like how it looked in my room. So I got this blanket from IKEA actually, and it's this weird like stretchy material, but I think it makes the chair look really cute. And I just have this butterfly pillow I got from IKEA. I'm pretty sure I got this pillow from like Home Goods or something. And then I just normally have some sort of purse or whatever laying here. Oh yeah, and before I go to my bookshelf, I will show you this little area. This is another favorite part of the room. This is just a little coffee table that I have and it's just a basic brown color. And I didn't think that it went really well with my room, so I decided to put some old scarves that I got from the thrift store. I thrifted all of these and I really just think it added a fun pop of color. I have this IKEA tree plant, some candles, a thrifted vase, some fake flowers, and this thing is actually so pretty and it is my great grandma's jewelry holder thing, I guess, and I really just like having it set there. And surrounding the table, I have these pillows that people normally sit at if they're eating or if we're playing a game on here or something. And I really thought that I never would have used that table like ever. Like I thought it would just be like decoration or I would just hold stuff on there. But I use it all the time. Since I don't have a desk in here, it kind of works as my desk and I will edit videos on it. Or if me and my friends are up here eating or something, we all eat on it. I really like playing this game called We're Not Really Strangers. I'll talk about it later. Now, the last part of my room is a lot going on, but this is my bookshelf. Originally, it was this wood color, and of course, like everything else in the room, I just painted over it with white. I definitely used a lot of primer and paint for this whole room, but I love how it turned out, and I really love this bookshelf because I just display a lot of things. And like you could tell from some parts of the rest of the room, I have a lot of little things that are really sentimental or have good memories attached to them. And that's like a lot of the things that are on my bookshelf. I'll start giving y'all a little tour of it and show y'all some of the stuff on here. So first of all, this is my manifestation journal. It is really cute. And then I just have the book sitting on this really cool mirror tray thing. In this corner, we have this little catch-all dish and it really just has random stuff. This is a plate I found from the thrift store and I really just like the colors of it. Another thrifted vase, and I just have these fake IKEA plants in it. This is another vase that I bought. This is a Five Below light, and this is a wine glass that I painted with my best friend this summer, and it was so much fun, so this definitely holds a lot of good memories in it. Coming over here, I have this old painting that I love the pastels and just faded look, and the frame is also really cool, and I got this from my stepmom a while back. This is a really cute little teapot, and I got this from the thrift store. Now over here is a thrifted basket that I got, and I just have a bunch of random scarves that I've thrifted over the year. Now for this row of the bookshelf, most of the things on here are thrifted too. This plate is thrifted. I have this cool leaf catch-all dish. This actually we found on my farm. This is a little succulent, probably from IKEA. Got this from the thrift store, might put some flowers in there. This is another little catch-all dish that my stepmom actually made me from pottery. And then next up right here, I have a couple books. This is one of my favorite books ever. I just finished reading it and I am obsessed. This is a really cool candle that I got from a flea market a couple weeks ago and I think it is the coolest thing ever. This is a little coaster thing that I painted with my boyfriend at Pots and Paints. This is an old vintage mirror. Not 100% sure where I got this. I feel like I've just always had this. Coming up here, I have another thrifted vase. This is just a random pot with a cactus that doesn't even fit in it. This is just another little dish I have, definitely from the thrift store. Now heading right here, this is a game called We're Not Really Strangers. I have a couple of expansion packs. This one is the relationship one, I believe. But if y'all don't know what this game is, check out their Instagram and you will be able to get some more insight on it. But it is so cool and I have cried many tears while playing this game, laughed a lot of laughs, and have gotten to know people in so many ways that I never thought that I would, so I really suggest this game. Just a little shout out, I am a big believer in it. And right behind it I have this thrifted painting, which I absolutely love. It's just some girls having a tea party. I have another little disco ball up here. This one's kind of small. And I have a We're Not Really Strangers sticker in front of it. This is just a little teacup that goes with this. I haven't used it yet. This is a relatively new thrift find. This is another thrifted vase, which I really liked a lot because I like having some pops of color. Like I have a couple random pops of orange. I have two other books up here, a claw clip. This is a pitcher that I use sometimes to water my plants. And I got this from the thrift store, of course. And in this corner, I have this string of pearls plant, which is fake. I wish it was real, but it is from IKEA. Now heading up to the top levels, I have just some hats, this pink cowgirl hat that I got for a trip to the Outer Banks last year, and just some other thrifted hats. And this purse is thrifted also. This, of course, is thrifted. And it's just this cool windmill thing. And then two more books up here. And that was a lot, but that's my bookshelf. A really in-depth tour of it. But I love absolutely everything on it. Oh my gosh. That was literally so much. Like, that was a lot to go through. And took me a lot longer than I thought I would. But I really hope that y'all enjoyed this room tour. I know that there's a lot going on. But I am so happy that I got to show y'all it. I have been wanting to do this video since I had the idea of redoing this room, and I'm glad that I'm happy with it enough now to finally do a room tour. And I just had so much fun getting things over time for it. Okay, my camera's about to die, but follow me on all of my socials, like and subscribe, and stay tuned for even more videos. And thank you so much for watching, but I will talk to y'all later.